Alright, and welcome back to lesson 3 of Cnc Lathe Programming. In the last 3 lessons, we talked about how to use the G71 and G72 roughing can cycles to rough the face, the ID, and the OD of a part. In this lesson, we're going to be talking about how to use the G70 finishing cycle to finish the geometry that was roughed by G71 and G72 can cycles. So let's take a look and see how that's done. Alright, so in lesson 1 and 2 we used the same shape and we talked about the G72 rough facing can cycle and the G71 rough OD turning. And so let's take a quick look and see what that looked like. We're taking a couple of passes to rough the face, and then we're going to go right into the G71 can cycle to rough the OD, taking 100 thousandths depth cut until the whole shape is roughed out, leaving 30 thousandths for a finish pass. Then tool number 2 finishes the face and finishes the OD. So let's take a look at the code and see how the G70 finishing cycle is used to finish both the face and the OD of this part. Alright, in lesson 1 we learned about the G72 rough facing can cycle, and we learned that we need to position our tool in the correct X and Z position before going into the G72 can cycle. Then we learned that the P and the Q refers to the end numbers down inside the geometry. Alright, so then in lesson 2 we learned about the G71 rough OD can cycle. And again there we learned that we needed to start the tool in the correct position before going into that can cycle. And there we also have the P and the Q value, which refers to the end numbers inside the geometry portion of that can cycle. Now in a lot of programs you're going to be using the G71 and the G72 in the same program. So what you need to make sure of is that the P and the Q values of each can cycle is going to be different, because the P10 Q11 is going to look for the N10 and N11 geometry, and of course the P12 and Q13 is going to be looking for the geometry between N12 and N13. Now it is the P and the Q values that I want you to remember here, because when we go to using the G70, that's exactly what we're going to be using to tell the G70 finishing cycle what geometry to finish. So for the facing, we're going to go back to the same exact start position in X and Z, and then tell it G70 P10 Q11. It looks back to the geometry between the P10 or the N10 and the N11 in the rough facing cycle and performs that tool path, leaving no extra stock. Then the finish OD does the exact same thing. We start it in the same exact position that we started the roughing can cycle. Then the G70 looks for the geometry between P12 and Q13, which is N12 and N13 of the geometry portion of the G71 can cycle. So you can see it just takes one line for the finish face pass and one line for the finish turning OD pass. So that's how G70 is used for finish facing and finish OD turning. So let's just go over real quick on how the G70 is used on ID finishing. And in lesson 2 we learned how to use the G71 can cycle to rough the ID of a part, and we learned that we need to stage the tool in the correct position before going into the G71 can cycle. Now let's take a look at this operation real quick. We're taking 80 thousandths per pass, retracting 40 thousandths at the end of each pass, leaving 30 thousandths on X and 10 thousandths on Z. And then the finish tool comes in and finishes that whole geometry in one pass. So let's take a look and see how the G70 code is used to finish what was roughed by the G71 can cycle. So we're looking at the code here used for the ID roughing, and we learned that we need to start the tool in the correct position in Z and X before going into the G71 ID roughing cycle. Again, we learned that the P and the Q refers to the N10 and the N11 geometry portion of the CAN cycle. And just like we just learned in OD roughing and OD finishing, the P and Q is used in the finishing cycle along with the G70 code. So again, we're starting the tool in the correct position and then just saying G70, P10, Q11. It looks at the geometry between N10 and N11, and that will be the finish pass performed with the G70 code with the finish tool. So you can see G70 makes writing code very simple. All right, so that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.